meeting to order. First, we've got David, if you could please take a seat. Just for the point of record for the camera, not Councillor Andrew Davis.
Yes.
Welcome to tonight's meeting of the Employment and Appointments Committee. First of all, can I thank all those in attendance, those who are here, and just ask if there are any declarations of interest that need to be given?
Can I ask a question?
Yes, of course.
I suppose this all goes to Stephen, I suppose, to Graham. Given what the legal counsel just said, would it be fair to say that the conduct of this meeting was very predetermined?
Well, I think that's often the case.
Were things discussed,
well, not predetermined, but obviously the decision's been made and the recommendation been given for this committee. And that's what we're here to discuss, is the recommendation.
Do you know what? I'm really interested, but I think that's Stephen, please.
Okay, sorry. There you go.
The answer is no, because you're at liberty to make such a decision as you want. I mean, it's just a recommendation for you. You can accept it or reject it as you wish. The same goes for the council and the matters considered there. I mean, the issue of the chief executive is, of course, ultimately a decision for the whole council.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Right, okay, we have a number of sets of minutes to approve, three sets, in fact.
Thank you.
concern. I don't know what the legal position is in terms of a decision will be made to make a number of people redundant based on dodgy bids.
Okay, you made your point, Jeff. What do you want to reply?
No, I think Jeff must have misheard what I said. I don't think I said I don't care what the figures are. I don't think I said that, which is what you said. I said that I agree with that. I think clearly we need accurate information. The point I'm making was in the context of the financial challenges they face and the proposal that we discussed, I would still have made the same decision. That's my personal view. I did not say, please don't accuse me of saying I don't care what the figures were. I did not say that. Just for the record, I did not say that.
Well, I'm grateful for the clarification that's been given to us tonight. I'm also grateful, Mark, for your follow-up on the item. It has been noted, and comments tonight have been noted, and are we happy to move on and approve the minutes as clarified?
Well, just to check what the net impact is. Does it mean that the decision has been made, it's not being going to be revisited, and this 200,000 whatever it was, this income was in and out of the result, is just another savings we'll have to make somewhere, or does it mean we need to lose another 200,000 household people, or what? Because it was sort of on sales, but I'm paraphrasing. It doesn't really matter. I'm just adding to the
agree.
So that's more AOB. We're also AOB. So
I'm a stakeholder in the So I've been given no other items on tonight's agenda, so I'd like to ask the Commissioner to talk us through the matter for consideration.
Chair. Agenda item 3 is the Employment Contract for Chief Executive and Head of Base Service. Senior Cabinet Receiver report dated to the Commissioner today concerning the employment of the Chief Executive. The Cabinet's advice to recommend that the Employment Promise Committee
the same mind. I'm not persuaded by the arguments he makes. You know, I do believe that, that Graham has demonstrated that he is merely moving this council forward on a whole range of fronts that I talk about, from the budget to the proposal process to the management restructure we just talked about, to the work that he's doing with the elected members of the Arts and the National City Region agenda. I think it's just slightly sort of bizarre that we were busy appointing two strategic directors and building contracts now, which is great, coefficient and Joe, Joe Grott, but the chief exec's on a short-term contract. I just think it sends out, I think, an important message of this key point in our recruitment journey, that we've got a chief executive who is here for the long term. And I think, I accept, Jeff, that you wanted to wait until later in the year. But I think, in my view, the longer the sort of uncertainty about Graham's position as chief exec, I think the more difficult the organisation. After all, in the last couple of years, we've had 3-4 chief executives, and I think that's part of our problem. And I think this really is, sometimes you've just got to think, you've just got to do the right thing to the right thing for the organisation. And that's what I'm suggesting, that this is the right thing. Clearly, this is a recommendation that will go to full council on the 28th, so members will have an opportunity to, all members will have an opportunity to make their views on it. But, I'm satisfied on the basis of the work that I've seen Graham do, knowing his track record, experience, obviously, I think it would be mad not to secure those services for a long time with you. So I certainly still believe that we should agree this. I know he's keen to sign the forms out. And actually, I think if you look at the financial kind of implications, I saw a post director of children's services last week in the authority, £160,000 per year, which is the kind of going rate for the DCS. So I think we are getting a very good deal here for the caliber of person. So I'm very happy to